Madden 19. I'm the coach. You're locked into the NFL on EA Sports. Coming up, we'll see a healthy Carson Wentz and the world champion Philadelphia Eagles face off against Drew Brees and the New Orleans Saints. With that, let's get over to the Mercedes-Benz Superdome with a call from New Orleans. Here are Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
First open back in 1975, there's a look inside the iconic Mercedes-Benz Superdome in downtown New Orleans. The setting in this dome just serves to amplify the excitement of the folks in New Orleans as their Saints burst from the tunnel a moment ago. They're set, and we're set as well as the Saints get ready to do battle with the Philadelphia Eagles. Along with Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. And Charles, you look at this Saints team as they interplay. They come in playing pretty good football, winners of four of their last six games. Meanwhile, for our visitors, the Eagles, they come in feeling good after back-to-back victories. Season has hit high gear, and off we go in week 11 on EA Sports. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll get it up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. And here come the Saints for their opening drive. They'll be led out by their veteran quarterback, the former Purdue Boilermaker. It's Drew Brees.
When I was watching film this week, I had to write a note to myself. Three touchdown passes in an NFL game deserves respect, not ho-hum just because they throw it around all the time. And he got his respect, NFC Offensive Player of the Week.
Yeah, it's the ultimate vote of confidence from a week ago. Ready, and look, he was great, not his best game ever, but obviously he's very good to go into that award. All the talk this week, though, was about, let's take that forward now. That's going to go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down.
Early down stuff to put this offense in a precarious position. We know that securing the point of attack, especially against the big-bodied guys in the middle of this D, has got to be priority one.
Ready?
On second down, Kamara. And he'll fight forward to about the 27-yard line. It's a gain of maybe three, but it's going to leave him with still about eight or nine to go on third down. Let's get a quick look at the Saints offense.
And we'll see the second half of their dynamic duo in the backfield, and that's Alvin Kamara, who in 2017, the NFL Offensive Rookie of the Year. How about this? Over 1,500 total yards and 13 total touchdowns in a debut performance. Expect more of the same and probably a little bit extra.
Now Brees on third down. And Gaines got it. And they get him down. Before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Brees to another long-time vet, him for the New Orleans first.
I think it all came together there. In-breaking route, drove it with excellent pace. Money throw right there to move the sticks.
Scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10.
Ready. Ready.
They go play action here on first down. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off by the linebacker, Najee Brown. And he will bring this across midfield. certainly not how they envisioned ending their opening drive here in the first quarter.
Too many ones in this play. First quarter, first drive, first interception thrown.
And that last one, that hurts. Here comes Eagle offense now as they get set to take over here. Here's Wentz. He'll buy some time right, and he'll get it down here to the 43. The improv on the scramble there gets him six, and it'll be second down.
Now, that was not a bad scramble there on first down. He didn't force it, nor did he throw it away. He was able to take off, and now he made it a very manageable second and short.
Numbers from last week's contest. Six catches, 62 yards.
And he's able to pull that last pass in, but this is usually a pretty tough unit to try and maneuver against. They're the top 10 in the league against the pass. And you and I both know there's not much difference between 1 and 10.
Embrace it to a journey. Give him 10 yards on that one, and that'll earn him a fresh set of downs.
Nice little nifty play for him there. Yeah, that's the ability to read a defense and utilize players that don't often get picked up in coverage easily. And I'm talking about being able to use the backs out of the backfield. Because I know that when I used to cover, hey, we got everybody covered. Oh, he just stuck out there, and they just got a nice first down there.
What do we love to say? Get those backs into space, right? They were able to do that there. Nice pickup on first down. Now Wentz. Oh, and 6 points in his hands there. Couldn't hang on. Second down.
Well, that certainly looked like something that they discussed all week in practice getting ready for this one. Take the big shot right out of the gate. At worst, you open up the defense a little bit. Loosen them up. Have them back on their heels.
Yeah, they are able to stop him, but he does take it all the way to the two. A good pickup there, a 22. Well, he did everything but get him in the end zone there, but now they're set up. Golden opportunity, strong opening drive, and they're knocking on the door.
And the way that they did it, now look where they are on the field. All right, this is naturally set up for a running play, isn't it? But with his ability to throw the football, his accuracy on this drive, you might want to think about a pass play in this situation.
Interesting. Time to find out. They'll try to run with a change. And forget about finding a lane. He barely had time to look up before he was planted in the backfield. It'll wind up being a loss of two, and that'll make it second and goal. They'll give it to him up the middle, and he's in for an Eagles touchdown. Jay Ajayi, his fifth touchdown now on the year, and the Eagles have taken the early lead. But there you go. That's not really too complex. Block, keep to your assignments, let them run it in. They did it.
Fundamental football. Good blocking, beats good tackling on that play, and result, touchdown.
On for the extra point, Jake Elliott. Elliott good on the extra point, and that makes the score 7-0. So that winds up a 7-play drive all told, and it's capped off by a touchdown run by Jay Ajayi. Elliott now to kick this one away. This is fielded at the goal line. And he'll take this across the 25. A couple extra. extra yards up to the 27-yard line. Now the Saints, they trot their offense out here. And, you know, certainly a lot of football left to be played. We're not into December yet, but right now where we stand, they're first place in their division, looking good, looking to be a threat come January.
And let's think about what every team has in their goals, right? Number one goal is what?
Make
plays. Number two goal is win your division. Number three goal, and the biggest goal, I think, is to be the highest seed possible that you can be heading into the playoffs, so you can have as many home games as possible to try and get you to the Super Bowl.
And right now, fighting for everyone possible to try to at least secure home field for the wild card and or divisional round. Facing a second and two after that last catch, good for 8 yards. Breeze leaves this one with Kamara. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. The numbers there for Kamara from a week ago. 19 carries, 56 yards, and a touchdown.
And give him a ton of credit. He's running the ball really well. But I look at those guys up front. That unit is truly playing as just that. Every move that they make, their teammate understands what that move means and what they need to do. And right now, the starter's lined it out pretty well.
And no room to maneuver there. Give him a yard up to the 47.
I know you feel that.
Time to peek at the defensive starters. Here they are for Philadelphia. They've had their trouble stopping the run, Charles. Currently 29th in the NFL in that department.
This is an area of the game that they definitely have to improve, because right now, against the pass, top 10 in the league. Against the run,
here we go.
That's where the struggles have come in. Got to find a way to make sure they stop runners before they get started.
Four down. Ready? We're waiting. Wait, set.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And they'll work this down to the 40-yard line. Tackled there. A good gain of 14 there, and it moves the chains. Alvin Kamara really settling into the league in his second season. And, of course, he came out of Tennessee, but not a lot of people remember he started at Alabama.
He did, and got caught in that big mix of running backs at Bama. And they like those bigger, thicker runners, those guys who can break down defenses through the middle. Alvin Kamara ended up leaving Alabama, going to a junior college for a while. I believe he went to Hutchinson Junior College before matriculating in Tennessee and finding his way to the NFL, where he is now a star.
Oh, look at Thomas wide open. And he'll get this one down to about the 20-yard line. Another big gainer that time. This one goes for 19 yards.
Well, coaches always talk about finding balance on offense. I didn't get much more balance than this. Big time run, big time pass.
A 1-2 combination. Looked pretty good.
How about that? Let's see if they can continue to take that kind of a punch, though.
First opportunity upcoming in the red zone for the Saints. First and 10 right at the 20.
Ready. We're waiting. Set.
Now a handoff. Here's Kamara. And he'll wind up losing yardage here back at the 21-yard line. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
I know the scouting report on him is that he doesn't possess the eye discipline to be an elite linebacker. What that means is his ability to read, react, and make a play. But on that one, he looked like one of those guys.
Maybe just a slight detour on what's been a strong drive. Here's second and 11.
Ready. Ready.
Again, this is Kamara. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. The Pro Bowler Fletcher Cox there to get him down.
Doubling this guy has to be a priority before moving up to the next level, because the big fella, he just ate that one alive, just stuffed it. In fact, before the game, he was talking to us, and he's like, hey, these pants make me look fat. And we said, nah, man, you're just a whole lot of guys.
He is well over 300 pounds. He's a big man. That's out to Hill, right side complete. They get only four that time, as that leads us to a fourth down.
And there's a completion to the tight end. And look at the size of these players nowadays. At that spot, 6'4", 6'5", and up. A lot of guys used to be basketball players, somehow came back to football. That's really good for the game of football. You're getting better athleticism, great hand-eye coordination. Guys who know how to control their bodies when they run their routes.
So the drive stalls out inside the 15-yard line, but they do get three.
And I'm tough with enough players nowadays that when they have these types of kicks, that no one says to their guy, hey, that's just like making an extra point piece of cake. Because the extra point is not a piece of cake anymore. But kicking a field goal from that distance, just give them confidence and let them knock it through.
This is fielded a couple yards deep. Now a hit and a loose tackle. And a penalty marker's down on the field. And they might be backing up a bit here to start the drive.
Illegal block in the back. Offense.
So they will accept the penalty and move forward. So from Philadelphia territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 22-yard line.
Ready!
Following the penalty, it's Kamara. And they'll get him down right about the 20. And a tackle there by Chris Long.
They'd love to just strike back with a touchdown right here. And if it's a long play, so be it. But the main goal, get a couple of first downs. Run some plays, run some clock. Allow their defense to get a chance to catch their breath, settle down, and relax a little bit after they just gave up the score.
Ready? You're ready.
On the ground, Kamara. And he'll at least get him inside the red zone here, down to about the 19. Tackle made that time by Brandon Graham.
Back-to-back runs, I'd say that encompassed maximum effort for minimal gain.
Minimal yardage, and now they're going to need something more than minimal on this play coming up. And before they can run another play, the clock hits triple zeros. And time is up on the first quarter. 7-3 the score. We'll head back to New Orleans after this.
The NFL on EA Sports is fueled by Gatorade, the sports fuel company.
With Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. It's Saints football to begin quarter number two. They'll need to convert a 3rd and 7, though, to start things out.
Ready? Ready?
Working from the gun. It's Breeze. It's Breeze. Sets up a 1st and goal.
Nice catch right there. Brings to mind the sentence. When in doubt, find your veterans.
We used to laugh back in the day when they would call guys like him crafty veterans. You get up in your 30s, you're still playing receiver, but you're around that long at that position, you're doing something right.
Just remember this. When he was young, he thought the crafty veteran was something that couldn't run anymore. Now he understands a little bit better.
Ready? You ready? We're done!
Try to pound it in, Kamara. And he is flying in the end zone. Touchdown, New Orleans. A great play there. His 6th touchdown of the season. And the Saints are able to cash in for 6. Solid job on the front. Really just a solid job all the way around to get that one in.
That was well executed, wasn't it? Well blocked, well run. End result, 6 points.
Touchdown. Good on the extra point, and the lead is now 10-7. A drive there of just 4 plays, and the capper came from Alvin Kamara on the touchdown run. Morstead, the punter, out to kick it off. This is fielded at the goal line. And he'll take this one near the 25, put at the 26-yard line. Now whistles, and we've got a man down. A man down here following the kickoff. While the trainers take a look, we'll step aside. Wentz and the Eagles now with a 1st and 10 at their own 26. Wentz now to throw. That's going to go as a loss of 4. That'll be 2nd down.
Back. 20.
the throw on second down. And his throw is incomplete. Alshon Jeffrey, the intended receiver, and it'll bring up third down.
And you see passes knocked down by those guys I call the frustrated fullbacks, the linebackers. You know that in their zone coverage, they're able to drop, see the ball thrown, and react to it very quickly.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. From the gun, it's Wentz. Dancing to his left. He may try and run for this. And he'll be out right at the 35. That scramble good for 13 yards, but not good enough for a first down. It's fourth.
Man, defensively, that hurts. They got him out of his rhythm. They had him hemmed in, but somehow he was able to tuck it away and get away for a gain.
So on fourth down, here's a veteran left-footed punter, Donnie Jones, to kick it away. Back deep, the veteran, Ted Ginn. And a great job here. This is going to turn out to be a beauty. This is marked down at about the 3-yard line. Down onto the field comes New Orleans. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline, because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet, see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things up.
They start the drive on the ground, Kamara. And he'll get this up past the 5 to the 7-yard line. They give him 4 yards there. It'll be 2nd and 6.
And that's frustrating for a defense because they've got him pinned down deep. And on the first play, they gave up a run that keeps an offense on schedule.
Because 3 to 4 yards, that's all you're looking for right there, right?
That's absolutely perfect, really, as a play call. You get 3 to 4 yards on first down. That's what they're talking about this all the time, about being ahead of the chains or on target, ahead of schedule. They were after that run.
And defensively, they were in zone coverage there. Do you have to be a little careful when you're losing, playing against a good quarterback like he is, to not play too much zone?
Yeah, you have to be careful about how much time you're giving up. I think it's a good point you just brought up. So maybe if you still want to play zone, you go to a zone blitz scheme, and you can drop anyone out of your defensive front, defensive end, defensive tackle. It doesn't matter. You just exchange someone to bring more pressure towards the quarterback and still try and cover downfield.
Call it a gain of 5, and that'll make it a 2nd down.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware a ball may come your way.
Ready! We're waiting!
On the ground, this is Kamara, and he'll be brought down here at the 28. Call it a gain of 4 there, so it sets up a big play here, 3rd and 1 yard.
On any running play that's called, they're always hoping that it's going to break big and go the distance. But when you get a nice game like that, you're able to do so many things anyway. You can come back and run essentially the same play again, continue to move the ball on the ground, or you can decide to throw the ball now because usually you have the defense back on its heels.
And he's able to get it to the 33. Good enough for a first down. 5 yards on the play there. It's a drive will continue.
That's about what you would expect since they're so efficient at picking up third downs in the top 5 in the NFL. It's all a mindset, and I guarantee you, it started in the offseason. Third down's important to them. They find a way to pick them up at a very good clip.
So they'll come up 1st and 10 now from the 33.
Ready.
Now a first down carry. It's Kamara. And he'll lose yardage. Brought down at the 32. It's a loss of a yard there, and now 2nd down.
I'm getting the sense that Fletcher Cox is making offensive linemen want to take the week off when they have to play against him.
It's a regular routine for him, isn't it?
It really is. That play there, that's him all day long. Good luck trying to block him and keep him from disrupting your offense.
Now they'll throw with Breeze. Now set up the screen now to Kamara. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. So the screen good for only 2. Now it's 3rd down.
So many things have to come together just right for a screen pass to break the big yardage. the blocking, the timing of the pass to the runner, everything has to fit together just correct. But on that play, the defense is able to just lock things and hold it to a short gain.
And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. And they convert on third with a gain of 22.
Ready? Ready?
Back to the ground. It's Camara. And he's taken down inside the 30. Back-to-back nice gains. That one for 14 yards and another first.
Now, this is an example of breaking down a defense, because on a lot of these runs, he's getting past the point of attack, and guess what he's doing? Forcing the secondary guys to have to make a lot of tackles.
Take it into the end zone for the Saints touchdown. A great effort there with his second touchdown of the game, number 7 on the year. And the Saints add on to their lead. And always a good first half when you can hit Baker twice.
And it never hurts to have that good feeling as the game moves on, just at about halftime. If that's his all he gets, he'll just sit there at the half and think, all right, two already. I can get some more. And he'll be encouraging his offensive line to create some space.
Lotso looked to add the extra point. Lutz with the extra point, and his guys will take a 10-point lead. Morstead, the punter, out to kick it off. This fielded a few yards into the end zone, and no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Philadelphia getting sent to take the field, and down on the scoreboard, certainly needing to avoid what happened on the last drive, punting the football.
Sense of urgency has to take over for them here. They know the score. They know the situation. And by the way, the punter no longer exists for their offense. That's how they have to treat this drive.
They need points.
Big time.
And they're able to get this one across the 35. Right off the bat, it's a first down to start the drive, 12 yards.
Tremendous blocking by the interior of the offensive line. They didn't just gash him there. They blasted a gaping hole for him to gallop through. And if he comes back to the armor, he better be giving them a whole lot of credit and thanking them for that much space to rumble.
It's a linebacker, Manti Te'o, on the stop.
What's the old expression? 3 yards in a cloud of dust? In this case, it's dust-covered pellets. It's no longer that old grass that we used to play on, right, and chew it up. Now, we've got that artificial surface. You see the pellets go up. Still a nice play by the defense.
And open left side, it's Williams. And he'll get up near the 45. They'll spot it at the 44. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down. He'll kick it away for the second time. 2 minutes to go here in the first half. We're back to New Orleans after this. And we'll remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll join Jonathan Coachman and the gang in Orlando. Coach will have stats and scores from the early games going on here around the NFL. Here's Donnie Jones now as he's on to punt for Philadelphia. He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. And he didn't quite have the backspin on that one. It hits at the 4 and continues into the end zone. It's a touchback. The offense and Alvin Kamara heading back onto the field at his current pace. Sure looks well in line for a 1,000-yard season, but Some of the older folks watching and remember the 12-game seasons in the NFL probably say, man, it was a lot harder to do that back then.
Yeah, even the 14-game season. And, you know, when we talk to those veteran runners, some of those guys who wear gold jackets, right, and appear in camp, they look at this and go, you know, it's kind of like going to school and taking 5 years to get your degree instead of just four.
A victory lap. They also used to walk uphill to school both ways.
In the snow.
In the snow.
Lizards.
Milk was 5 cents. Hey, but he's having a great year, not to take anything away from him.
It certainly feels like there are more stars at the tight end position than there were even 10 years ago. And I think it's become more of a glamour position because of the ways it can hurt a defense, and guys want to be involved. They can be in line, close to the line of scrimmage. They can split out like receivers. But hands, route running, speed, and some toughness to go across the middle. You put it all together, you got a heck of a tight end candidate.
He's got a man open. It's Cameron Meredith. And they bring him to the ground just shy of midfield. A nice pickup there of 11 yards, and it'll move the sticks.
We didn't need to ask around the league, but we got to confirm this guy's a good player. They've got to find a way to get him more involved, call a few more plays that target him.
Absolutely, because here we are toward the end of the first half, and that's the first target, not just the first catch, first target. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Throwing on first down is Breeze. Gets it to Meredith, complete. And before the second down play, we'll get a whistle, a signal, and a timeout. As they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. Six yards was the pickup on the last completion, so here's second and four. Again, it's Breeze. On target over the middle of the hill. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. And get a quick timeout called by New Orleans, number two. As the clock will stop with 45 seconds to go in the first half. Breeze going to come up here, first and 10. And he's 4 for 4 now, throwing the ball to start the drive.
Ready, double waiting.
Breeze to throw again. And throwing it over the middle. And maybe a little shy of the 25 here at the 26-yard line. That's a staple of this offense. Drag route to the tight end.
Yeah, he's unable to use his size to break off much more yardage after the catch, but still an effective gain nonetheless.
Able to get 7 on that first down pass play. Second and 3.
Ready, yellow lady, yellow lady. Ready,
now, Breeze again. And that's caught by Meredith. 50 catches for him now on the year. He's got a first down. Breeze now. Still just the one incompletion. 16 of 17. It's first down. And not able to get it that time. He hit on 6 straight passes. Not there. Second down.
Ready. Ready.
Again, they'll throw with Breeze. Drops this off to Kamara out of the backfield. Call it a pickup of 7. And that's going to lead to a third down.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
Now Breeze. That is quick with the 7-yard line. And he gets the first down yardage he needs before he's brought down at the 6. Give him a gain of 4, able to convert, and that sets up first and goal now. Now Breeze. That's caught. So it's halftime here in New Orleans with the Saints out in front. As we send you on over to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman in our EA Sports Halftime Report. Take it away, Coach.
All right, Brandon, thanks very much. Things starting to get interesting in this final weekend before Thanksgiving. So let's see what's going on around the NFL. We'll begin in the NFC. Dallas paying a visit to Atlanta. And it's the Cowboys on top as they play the second quarter. The Cowboys had a brilliant first half of the season, Now they're looking to get to 8-1 with a victory. From there, let's head up to Baltimore to check in on the Ravens at home at M&T Bank Stadium. And for the moment, they find themselves trailing the visiting Cincinnati Bengals. John Ross, a touchdown reception. Lastly, let's get you to MetLife Stadium to see what's happening with the Giants at home in East Rutherford. And they've got the lead in their matchup with the Tampa Bay Bucs. Russell Shepherd, a touchdown reception. In our game, it was the right arm of Drew Brees that led the way in the first half. He's thrown for close to 200 yards already, and that's helped propel his guys into the lead. As we send you back to Brandon Godden.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. Set now to go for the third quarter. The Saints have the lead and set to receive the kick. Turn here, he gets it out to the 25-yard line. Out come the Eagles now as they'll go on offense first here in the third quarter. They have the ball here for the inaugural drive of the second half. Pretty big deficit, though. We'll see what adjustments were made in that locker room.
And I never want to make something more important than it actually is, right? I don't want to create more hype than what is there. You're not doing it, though. This is a really important drive. And we often talk about teams scripting plays to start a game. A lot of them script to start the second half, too. And they're scripting something that they expect to get them into the end zone and back into this game.
We'll see if that script is a good one for them. They stay on the ground. Again, it's a Johnny. And he'll bring it up here to right at the 40-yard line. It'll go as a gain of six that time, and it moves the chains as well.
Second and one, and people want to run the football. This is what every back in the league is supposed to do, exactly what we just saw there. Pick up the first down.
Hang in there now. Hang in there now.
Can't find one. Stopped at the line of scrimmage. You know, despite the scoreline, I think they've got to like where they are here. They're on the road and just one big play away from getting right back in this game.
I'm going to follow right along with you because the spot they're in now is a credit to their defense. They've kept their minute by making the plays that they've made, and that just means they're one big score away from being right back.
Now the question is, can this offense step up and make that play? Because that's been an issue for them in this game. First target, first catch, and a first down.
One thing I can say pretty safely, that route is not called if you don't have a guy who can throw the ball and put some mustard on it. Because if you're going to lollipop it in the middle of the field, bad things usually happen. It takes a strong-armed guy who can rifle it in there, and they were able to successfully complete that one.
And first down, Wentz. And this will be incomplete. There defensively to break that one up, Ken Crawley.
It's always a battle. Who's going to win on first down? The offense or the defense? Let's face it, if you've got the ball, 4 yards or more on first down is what you're aiming for. They tried to throw for it there. Nice effort to knock that one away and bring up second down.
Here we go.
Once again here on second and 10. And the Saints pressure gets it. Brought down for a sack. Sheldon Rankins in there to drop him for his fifth sack of the year.
Well, the beauty of screen passes is they take a little time to develop, and it can often hit big. But sometimes they take too long to develop, and sometimes you get sacked.
Yeah, what's perfectly called for a defense to attack a screen?
Typically a blitz, and even though people think that the screen operates against the blitz, if you have the blitz called and you still cover the screen, that allows your blitzers to get there.
Eagles coming up here on a third and long, so Wentz and company with some work to do after the sack. A bullet throw, but incomplete.
Now we're into the second half now. This is an offense that continues to struggle to sustain a drive.
Looks like they're just totally out of sync, whether they're running the ball, passing the ball like we saw there. I don't know. The rhythm seems off. Here's Donnie Jones now as he's on to punt for Philadelphia. And that one hits a little too close to the goal line, and it continues into the end zone for a touchback. The offense and Alvin Kamara heading back onto the field. And he's found the end zone twice, and now I'm guessing he's thinking, hey, let's find it three times.
And you got got to figure from the defensive perspective, how's he gotten there twice? What are we going to do to keep him out for a third time? How do we tame things down? Because he and his offensive mates, they're really in sync right now.
Gets this to the 24 for a gain of 4.
Oh, yeah.
Third quarter, you've got the lead. You're not ready to go into that 4-minute offense to close the game out, but a running game can really benefit your team right now.
They'll come up 2nd and 6 now from the 24.
Dropped the defensive end out. He ended up with an interception in that game in Super Bowl 50. Maybe some sort of scheme like that to try and get more pressure off the passer.
And he's got it up over the 40 to the 41. It's a 6-yard pickup, but it gets him to 2nd and 4.
And there we saw one of the downsides of blitzing during a rundown, because sometimes you get out of your gaps. You don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon.
Ready.
Breeze to throw on 2nd down. And Watson has it right side. And he'll get up near the 45. They'll spot it at the 44. Only 3 yards on the catch. It's 3rd down.
Well, they were unable to make anything really big out of that, but it's not a bad idea to find your tight end and give him an easy completion and keep moving things forward. Almost as bread and butter as a good running back dive play.
The Saints on 3rd down. They have been superb. 5 for 6 to this point. They're up against a 3rd and 1 situation.
Ready.
Here's Kamara trying to run for it. And he's got the first down as he's up to the 45-yard line. He needed a yard. That's what he got. And it's going to earn him a new set of downs.
Someone's been having a good game so far. You know something? Watkins got power running. They decided to turn him loose again on 3rd down, didn't they?
They did indeed. He delivered the tough yards.
Ready. We're waiting.
Breeze now on 1st down. The catch made up in the middle of the game. And he'll work it across midfield inside the 45. Give him 11 yards that time and a new set of downs.
Yellow lady, yellow lady.
Breeze now on 1st down. And Thomas has it. And he's going to get this inside the 30. Another nice gain, 16 yards there, and a 1st down again.
Find that one in there. Make connection on a nice in route.
With those faster passes and they're going that fast, any hesitation as a quarterback that the deflection, if you miss, might be bigger and lead to an interception?
Yeah, and the deflection works both ways. Maybe a defender gets a hand in the way and it pops in the air. And sometimes you throw it so hard your receiver can't handle it, and he pops it up in the air for the defenders to grab as well.
But a moot point there as they were able to connect.
Ready.
The man who's been busy this afternoon, it's Kamara again. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. He'll get a nice chunk there on the 1st down run, and it's 2nd and 4.
Looks to me like maybe there's a little attrition setting in with this drive, because when you see that type of a run, I get the feeling the defense get a little bit tired.
And that's the last thing they need, especially when they look up at the scoreboard.
Ready.
Now Breeze throwing on 2nd down. Completes this one to Meredith. And they'll bring him down at the 13-yard line. What a methodical drive this is turning out to be. That time 9 yards, and the sticks move again.
One of the selling points of the in route is it gives the quarterback a really nice sight line to his receiver, and almost on a direct shot, able to throw the ball into the middle of the field and have a great chance of success, as they did on that play.
Breeze going to come up here 1st and 10, and he's hit on all 5 of his pass attempts on this drive so far.
Ready.
Breeze gives it up to England, and he'll find his way down yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
Let's give a lot of credit to the offensive line. They've been able to move the ball really well on the ground the entire game. And while that wasn't a huge one, that's okay. They'll take them in short, steady bursts.
They stay on the ground. This time it's Kamara. And able to push his way forward here for a good little game. 5 yards on the pickup, and it'll be third down.
I think we can safely say that those types of plays are the backbone of this offense. We know not every run's going to be a big hitter, but you know they'll take that type of result on each and every attempt.
Hey, ready? You ready?
Brees going to try and throw on third down. Check down, he finds Kamara. And he will have the first down before he's brought down at the 3. Give him a gain of 4, able to convert, and that sets up first and goal now. Well, they've had a great, impressive drive going here, and that pickup ensures the drive continues.
And not only do you continue the drive, which is demoralizing for the guys on the defense side of the ball right now, but you make your own defense happy. They're able to get a little more rest over on the sidelines while this one continues downfield.
They'll run it with Kamara. Buster. Ball is right into the end zone for a safe touchdown. A great play there. A 3-yard touchdown run. And the Saints now add 6 to their lead.
That drive that really increased their cushion felt very military to me. Very precise, methodical, as one of the words you've taught me. And they just got it done.
And slowly but surely now starting to pull away a little bit. Things looking good for them here in the third quarter.
Not only pulling away, but you mentioned that slowly but surely. You also drain clock, too, with a drive like that. So you really give yourself an advantage.
That's good on the extra point. And that'll make this a 3-score game now. The lead moves to 17. This one fielded at the 5. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. Philadelphia getting set to take the field. And right now these guys, they're shuffling a little bit, maybe doubting, because 3 straight drives have ended with them punting the football away.
Yeah, so you start pointing fingers at each other a little bit, asking a lot of questions. What are you seeing? What are you getting? Maybe trying to narrow down your playbook a little bit and maybe get simpler rather than more complex in order to try and fashion together a drive.
They run with Ajayi. And he'll go down right at the 30-yard line. Tackle there going to Marshawn Lattimore.
Well, it's time for them to be good teammates right here. And what I mean by that is possess the ball for a little while. Get at least 2 first downs. Give their defense a chance to settle down a little bit after they give up a touchdown.
Here we go. Now Wentz throwing on second down. And this is incomplete.
The struggles finding open receivers continue. I don't know the last time I saw this inconsistent during the football.
It would be hard to find a day when he was this inconsistent. You know, in his locker, he keeps the word poise printed on an 8.5 by 11 sheet of paper. He needs to find that poise right now.
He certainly does. In fact, I would suggest he laminate it.
Now Wentz on third down. We saw this a lot in the first half, and it continues. These receivers just not able to get much separation.
So that means they have to win the 50-50 balls. They've got to go up with the defender and find a way to start coming down with it.
And this time, contact and another incomplete pass. Here's Donnie Jones now. He's been one of their few bright spots so far. Now it's Ginn. A good return there, coming 13 yards. And the Saints will take over with a first down and 10. The offense and Alvin Kamara heading back onto the field. He's had a touchdown for every quarter so far. 3 here in the third, and probably hoping he's not done yet.
And this is a situation where it's okay to be greedy. When you've already scored 3 times, you want 4, you want more than that, and guess what? That only helps your team.
Yeah, so far 3, now in search of 4.
ready?
They begin on the drive with Kamara. And he'll fight forward to about the 27-yard line. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a 2nd and 9.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping is big defense.
And he fires one that's intercepted. Breeze picked off by his former teammate, Malcolm Jenkins. And he's going to get this one to the 23-yard line. Well, they needed a break. They needed to make a play here in the third quarter. Defensively, they did that. Now they got to go quickly and get some points on the board.
And the best part is that they made their own break, taking the ball away. Now they just look at their offense and say, guys, let's go. Come on, capitalize on this one.
And he'll keep it moving down to the 15-yard line.
First play of the drive. Let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking, but the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. Back now here live in New Orleans. It's the Eagles behind on the scoreboard, back with the football here as we start the fourth quarter. They run again with a giant. And they get to him quickly here as he stopped right around the 13. It'll be a gain of 2 on the play, but they'll remain a few inches short here with 3rd down looming.
Defense is always talking about earning the right to rush the passer on 3rd down. And you know what offenses want? Win 1st down so they can set things up for themselves better.
Well, that wasn't helpful there. Not a big impact on 1st down. And he gets the 1st down yardage he needs before he's brought down at the 6. They're able to convert on 3rd down, and that sets up a 1st and goal.
Would it be safe to say that as precise as routes are supposed to be run in the NFL, maybe they're not quite as precise in college ball?
That's accurate, yeah.
And I think we saw a college route in the NFL there. Just find the soft spot, find the dead zone, and find the 1st down. And that's what he just did.
From the gun, it's Wentz. They dump off underneath to a Ajayi. Nothing on that one. It'll be 2nd down.
Well, that was a simple throw and catch, but even with that completion, 0 yards gained, so they're behind schedule on down and distance.
I think they were hoping to get it to him. He could make a man or two miss, but that window closed quickly. Shot from the 6-yard line, and it's 2nd and goal now.
Here we go.
Working from the gun, Wentz. This is caught, and he'll be brought down here at the 3-yard line.
Come on now.
3 yards there on the completion. That'll lead to a 3rd and goal.
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position because he creates mismatches with his size. The slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
He needed 3, he got 2. Now that'll set up an interesting situation here on 4th and 1.
Well, Brandon, we always know that once you score 1 touchdown,
you're
without a doubt. And so far today, he's got 1, but was denied as he tried to get the 2nd one.
And Elliott puts this one through. And high fives for that one as that drive ends in 3. Well, with that field goal, you can argue they needed to get back within 2 scores, and they did indeed do that, but still a pretty uphill battle.
Still going to take 2 fourth quarter touchdowns to get back into it. And as you and I know, that's a tall order against any NFL defense. They're going to need their own defense to make some plays as well to give them an opportunity.
This is Fielded at the goal line. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. Drew Brees getting ready to go again on offense. And he comes out on the heels of an interception he threw last time they had the ball.
Yeah, and you know, the quarterbacks that I know that are the best ones, the ones that really know how to lead their team, they tell him, that's on me. That's my bad. Let's go back out there and move ahead again, guys. We can get this done.
One good thing for him. It did only lead to 3 points and not a touchdown after that time.
Big thanks to the defense.
And he nearly get this all the way to midfield. Marking down at the 49. Great way to start the drive. 20 big ones and a first down. So one play, and they're already just shy of midfield. To midfield. Let's say, they'll spot it right at midfield at the 50. It'll be a pickup of only a yard, and that'll bring up second down.
But it's tough to be a defender in today's NFL because there's so many things to account for in today's passing game, including the back sneaking out of the backfield. Not quite as bad as a turkey bowl where you have that center eligible stuff, but still a lot of guys to account for.
Elsewhere, they're into the fourth at FedEx Field. You saw the score at the bottom of your screen a moment ago. We got a good one going on there. DeAndre Hopkins, only a couple yards shy of 100. He's at 98 receiving to this point.
Right.
They'll run it now. Out of the gun. And good penetration here. He'll get this down only to about the 49-yard line. Only a yard on the pickup. And now they've got a third down and 8.
Bottom line, they want to keep this clock rolling. So they'll take that one right there. They just want to keep falling forward. And they want to put the onus on the big fellas up front in order to bring this one home.
Ready. United. Set.
Now Breeze on third down. And incomplete here on third down.
I remember a coach telling me a long time ago the difference between playing corner and safety in the NFL. Corner is like the autobahn. Everybody just flying by. And these corners have been really busy in this game, although they got it done on the last play.
On the last play, yes, but there have been some good numbers put up against them offensively. Here's Thomas Morstead now, as he should be able to pin him back deep here with his first punt. Set to take the field. And tough to win games if you're going field goal, field goal, field goal here. They got field goal last time. Now they'll be looking for a touchdown.
They're looking for the big chunk now because, as you noted, the field goal, field goal, field goal way of doing it makes it that much harder and puts more pressure on every possession for you now. Go ahead and get six and feel a lot more comfortable about the position they're in.
Bigger chunks. We'll see if they can get the score. Interception made by Alshon Jeffery. And they work this well upfield across the 45. And that one results in 35 yards. Fourth quarter, every drive so critical, and you figure may only get one more shot after this, so a touchdown's imperative on this drive.
It is, but you also have to think to yourself in play calling, don't hold anything back. Don't save it for the second touchdown. You got the first one for the second.
Come on
now.
Let's go.
The big play has him all the way out near midfield for a first and 10. They'll run it now out of the gun. And a well past midfield, just a yard or two shy of the 40. They pick up 12 on the play there, and they move the chains.
Well, partner, I know this type of running back. I mean, this size, this intensity usually gets better as the game goes on. I just tell you from experience, the first few quarters, oh, you're eager. You come running up there. I'm going to tackle this guy. By the fourth quarter, you're coming up and thinking about it.
And D-line wearing down fourth quarter. Yeah, that's not a guy they want to see consistently. Going on first is Wentz. And it's caught over the middle. Wilson. And this time not quite to the 30. He'll be down at the 31-yard line. Give him 9 there on the first down completion.
You can see the time and effort and thought that they put into their passing game because it was evident right there. It looks like a simple pitch and catch, but you and I both know that they have planned for this and worked hard to make it happen.
Hang in there,
that last
hang
catch
in there now.
Short of the marker by just a yard leaves him with a very manageable second and 1. Shotgun now for Wentz. Intercepted it. They haven't picked a ball off yet. That probably should have been there first. And it's third down now.
Didn't have a receiver open downfield, as it turned out. Couldn't even find his outlet man because of the coverage. It was way too tight. Unable to find anyone open.
The Eagles on third down. They've had their troubles. Just 1 for 6. They need just a yard here. It's 3rd and 1. Wentz going to throw. They set up the screen to Ajayi. And he gets this one inside the 15, just a yard or two shy of the 10. It's a gain of 20 and picking up the first.
But correct me if I'm wrong, you know, you're down 2 scores. I don't think you need to rush just yet, but you can't take your time either.
Yeah, even if you don't want to commit to full 2-minute offense, you have to up the tempo, up the urgency. Maybe you're starting to call 2 plays in a huddle each time you snap the ball.
Check on the scoreboard. Under 4 to go now as they come up on 2nd down. They'll run with a former Badger. It's Corey Clement. Pretty little juke move there on a nice game. 9 yards on the pickup there as he'll be left with 3rd and 1.
Well, as the play call comes in on 3rd down, you have to think about 4 down territory here. Down a few touchdowns, they need points, and they need big points.
The Eagles on 3rd down, lacking much success, just 2 for 7 to this point. They're up against a 3rd and 1 situation. Wentz now throws. He rifles one, it's intercepted. Picked off by Marcus Williams. And a little stop shy of the 15 at the 14-yard line on the return.
Partner, we always talk about possessions being at a premium in these games, and now in this situation, throwing an interception here when you have to claw your way back in, that one's going to hurt, and in a big way.
Out onto the field comes New Orleans. Turnover that just got them the football back, obviously a big one, because had they been able to score on the other side, this would have been a 1-possession game.
So you don't sense full relief here, though?
No, I don't. Especially with the ball this deep in their own territory, because you make a mistake, they've got it right back in prime position.
They certainly do. So now, almost like a 4-minute offense, right? Take care of this bad boy. Make sure the other team doesn't touch it, but move it with consistent gains. Get down the clock and make them use their timeouts in this situation.
Got to figure now, after getting that turnover, they're just going to be happy to keep the ball on the ground, right?
This is where covering the football, taking care of the ball, all the ball security terms that have ever been used, they come into play for the guys on offense, right? Just take care of it, and they got a good chance of ending up winning this game.
And not a whole lot to speak of there, as they'll bring him down shy of the 20. Give him 3 on the run there. Now they're looking at a 3rd and about 5.
And this is an absolutely big 3rd down that's been set up here, partner. And there's no other way to put it. The defense has to get a stop here if they have any hopes of winning this game.
Astor, you said big 3rd down. I put the word big in capital letters here. So it's Saints football as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Now this is a big 3rd down, and you'd have to think we'd see a timeout right away if they can't stop him here.
Ready? You ready?
From the gun on 3rd down, Breeze. That's complete to Meredith. So flush out of the 2-minute warning, and here's another timeout taken with 1:55 remaining. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up 1st and 10.
Hey.
Ready? You ready?
Camara. And he'll work this one up to about the 38. And now we're going to get a timeout defensively. So another stop, 1:50 left in the football game. The Saints on third down. They've been tough to stop. 8 for 10 so far. This is 3rd and 8.
Ready.
They'll run. This is Kamara. And for the moment, this will be a first down. But we have a marker on the field. Let's see if this stands.
Illegal block in the back. Offense.
So this will be accepted as it moves the offense backwards.
Also make plays himself, as we just saw there.
Here's Thomas Forstead now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. Take the field. And there are parts of their last drive they'd like to emulate. Of course, they'd like to forget the ending, the interception, but they did put together, Charles, a nice sustained drive to get him down the field.
Yeah, and unfortunately for them, the only thing that matters is part two, right? Because once they threw the interception and finished off the drive, that does them no good to go back and say, well, you know what, a good one going. Finish things off. That's all.
The drive hit. He wants the football. The Saints say they have, and they do.
In the case of wanting to put points on the board, it was needing to, having to, and they didn't get it done.
Yeah, didn't get it done, and now you look at the situation and the point differential, 2 scores, pretty much game set now.
How about the takeaway, though, huh? How about those defensive guys?
How does the Saints' offense now as they get ready to take over here? They were forced to punt last time, and I doubt sincerely that they'll have to punt here because they're gifted with terrific field position.
I don't even want to think about the idea that they would end up punting starting with this type of field position. Neither do they. Great starting spot, great opportunity to run your full playbook. They want to take a shot here, they can go ahead and do it.
Hey, ready.
The Saints in victory formation now as they'll take the knee. The chance of wasting this great starting field position, a real threat. This is 3rd and long. And Charles, I think when the schedule comes out, all teams, no matter where they're predicted to finish, talk about protecting your home turf. They were able to do that here in this one.
Similar to a tennis match, right? Not letting them break your serve. That way you hold on to it. They got it done, and they feel very good about that victory.
So for New Orleans, they keep pace for a playoff spot as they move to 7-3. And they'll get to stay put for a few days as they'll host the Atlanta Falcons next week. Meanwhile, for the Eagles, it was a game they really needed as they drop back to 4-6. And they will be at home next week to take on the New York Giants. That'll do it for us. I'm Brandon Gauden, alongside Charles Davis. Thanks to our entire crew as well. We'll talk to you next time. So long, everybody.